Bonjour fragrance lovers, this is Clémence. I'm talking about fragrance and welcome back. Morning face! I look so tired. Today it's my second vlog and for this vlog we're gonna go fragrance shopping. First of all, I'm gonna get ready. We're gonna have a little chat before and then after we're gonna go to Chanel because I've got some friends over there and I didn't give them Christmas gifts, so I need to go to give them Christmas gifts. I'm quite excited because we're gonna go to Harrods together. When I'm going fragrance shopping, it's or Harrods or Jeveux. I love Harrods. I know for some people it's like a big machine of consummation or stuff like that, but I personally worked in Harrods as well, like a few years ago. First of all, because you get so many different fragrances, so many different brands, it's actually crazy and you discover a lot of things. My main thing is Salon de Parfum and this is where I want to take you today. So I can't guarantee I'm gonna have like proper footage. I remember when I was working in Chanel, it was, you couldn't film inside. But I'm really stressed. I didn't really go out since January. January I went back to France, unless to go to the supermarket or to see my friend and neighbor Martina. I'm always like really extremely social, so for me it's strange. I'm also stressed and I wanted to talk to you about that, like, because I know some of you know, it's like, if you follow me you probably have heard some stuff, but I really want to let you know because as you can see on YouTube, I'm not very always a bit up and down. So some weeks I'm gonna create a lot of videos and some weeks I'm not gonna do a lot. I'm really sorry about that. I just wanted to tell you, I thought 2020 would be the worst, one of the worst years of life because I couldn't go traveling and I was complaining. I was like, oh, I can't go on holiday, you know, it's so sad and blah, blah, blah. Well, 2021 is starting really lovely for me. I was like, oh, how can it go worse? Well, there we go. It can actually go worse. Yeah, I've got kidney little problem. My kidney is not in a really good condition. Since the beginning of the year, I keep having like crisis and keep going to hospital. Last time I stayed a week over there to get transfusion every morning. On Monday I came to do an exam, but they told me that I was doing an infection again, which is really bad news because then I had a little intervention that was supposed to happen and we can't do it anymore because I've got that, so we need to cure that. At the moment I'm under this treatment. Once I recover, we'll have to go back to hospital for that. So it's more that I'm not used to live like this. It's really difficult because I'm very energetic, I'm hyperactive type of girl, and you know, usually I worked like probably like 10 hours a day for my job or a bit less sometimes. And then after that, I like work on my own stuff all night and I'm used to do like that, and all weekend I do that, you know. I'm used to do that and I really don't mind, I really like it, it's how I am. Like, if I'm not working, I want to work. Like, I'm always like this, so you know, it's me. This time I have to say it doesn't work, like, and it makes me feel really sad because, oh my god, like, no emotion, Clémence, please, no emotion. Because like sometimes, like for example last week I wanted to do a video in French on the Saturday and I couldn't wake up. I, you know, like it was like I was hangover, like massively hangover, and you know those massive hangover where you can't stand. That was me, but I didn't do nothing like the day before. It's killing me because I want to do it but I can't, like I physically can't. So whenever I feel better, I try to do stuff because it makes me feel better myself. And you know, like a lot of people tell me, like, Clémence, you need to rest, you need to rest. I don't want to rest. That's the thing. It depresses me. Like, I'm a working girl. Like, since I'm a baby, probably I'm like hyper dynamic and working and working. I used to have my mom when I was a teenager, you know, at the bakery because my parents got a bakery. And you know, like I'm like that, I'm like, you know, I like to work. And if I don't, I feel useless. I wanted to let you know that this is happening. Not because I want to be you on comment like, oh, poor Clémence. No, no, please don't. Like, honestly, please don't. I'm okay. I feel I need to let you know because sometimes people are like, oh, can you do that? Can you do that? Or especially with the French video, like people are like, why Why are you not doing as much content? I'm just finishing my makeup and I get you back. Voilà. I'm just gonna get ready with my clothes because I need to look extra cute for Harrods. I don't know if you know a little bit the place, but it's like a palace and you can't go in Harrods in like you're going to Tesco. No. And I'm also planning to buy something and I'm so excited! Just a quick shot before I'm starting to get like dressed, but I just received a new fragrance and I'm like, hallelujah. This is from Miller Harris. You know how much I love Miller Harris fragrance, Titanic. I love my Lever Rouge, my Scherzo. I receive Lumière Dorée. So I already have this fragrance, but in a tiny little bottle. And I was like, I don't want to use it. Oh, so I'm so happy. I've got a big one and it's one of my favorite Neroli. It smells a bit like baby powder, lots of orange blossom, you know, you can really feel that. I have slightly a sweetness, it's like a slightly cozy, cocooning sweetness Neroli, and I just adore it. And yesterday, I received Théo Cabanel Oh La La, which is a bomb of an iris fragrance. Slightly gave me a vibe of Dior Homme at the beginning, but then I feel it's much more focused on the iris, so... super powdery, super intense with a creamy undertone. It's just bomb! I love it! I'm all good to go. And what do we wear to go to Harrods? You need to wear the taff one. Even if it's sunny, it's time to wear something ultra luxurious. And for that, I want to test my little encensoir from Matière Première outside. I want a big sillage. I want people to be like, whoa, my God, like she smells, you know. So, yeah, I'm just gonna put a jacket and we're gonna go to Chanel and then Harrods. Here you can see Covent Garden. I didn't film my little part in Chanel because I was with all my friends. So I didn't think at all about filming because I was having a good time. Then we're going to Knightsbridge Station to go to Harrods. Here you are in the main fragrance hall. As you can see, there's a lot of different fragrance. Now we go into another part of the store. So as you can see, it's more like a little open boutique of different brands. So it's very pretty.
Look how beautiful this is. Stunning.
Little stop to Tom Ford and the new Baby Soleil Brûlant. It's supposed to be a citrus ambery fragrance, slightly sunny, but I didn't really feel that much, more pink pepper to me.
So we are in Tom Ford and I've just tried the new one, which is Soleil Brûlant. I'm not too sure about this one. I think I prefer the classic, like Soleil Blanc. So that's the one. Good. And there is Tuberose Nue. Again, not too sure. It's nice, but I was expressing, I don't know, I wanted something different. It's really simple, but nice, but simple. That's with Gia. I did try the fragrance. Not too sure about them, but look at this packaging. I mean, how crazy is that? So you can basically just pick those and smell it, and you have the scent. Thanks. So is that new?
Nice. From today.
Is that bergamotto? Did you had it before?
Yeah, but this is a new one because the extraction always different and also the ingredients.
Mm.
Usually my favorite, guys. I'm in love from this. Wow, I love this. So that's the oil, like you said. Oil, this is nice, guys. Very girly.
Explosive to carrots only.
Yeah. Ooh. Look at this, guys. So this is a candle, only sold in Harrods. It's like £500 something. And look at this gorgeous packaging. I mean, you know where your money is going, but the scents are absolutely stunning. Very powdery, elegant. I love it. So what we've done, we've put that little bit oudi oil, super concentrated, and put this one here. And together, guys, that is bomb. The oil from Gucci, have to try. Okay, now we're going to Salon de Parfum, guys. So let's go. It's the 6th floor. A lot of fragrance. I've tried with my friend some Gucci, so I've got some sample of it over there. And now we're gonna go Salon de Parfum, my favorite place in the world. I'm basically just looking for a bathroom, but I'm like, where is it? It's like a maze, honestly. Gosh, look at that bed. It's crazy. Oh, hello. Right, nearly there. Some shoes. Finally, heaven is there. The Salon de Parfum. Let me introduce you to the best place in the world, guys. Not joking, this is where you need to go. Right. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. There we go. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Good, thank you.
So they all come like this, in this beautiful packaging, and it's a bento-inspired box. So beautiful. We have the 50ml bottle, and this is the cap.
Yeah.
We take off the cap, and then we have an extra 10ml which goes in the cap. So this becomes your travel spray.
That is so nice. I heard
50ml and a 10ml travel size, so you get 60ml all in total.
That's nice.
And the bottles are refillable.
Do you have? So I heard about one fragrance. One of my friends, fragrance YouTuber, told me there's a fragrance that smells very like a cake a bit.
Yes, it's One Umbrella for Two.
Ah, that's it. Exactly, that's the one. Thank you.
One Umbrella for Two. It's a very special smell with blackcurrant, gin maïs châtié, and cedar oil. Gin maïs châtié with a type of red tea marinated in brown rice.
And like a cake, but fruity. Wow, so that's blackcurrant absolute gin maïs châtié. Oh my god, that's stunning. Which one is your favorite?
Now I have a lot of different favorite ones, but one of my favorites is I Met a Flower.
Mm-hmm.
We launched on our Instagram.
Oh, I didn't see. I'm so bad.
So this is
so that's Harrods on there. Oh my
so
god,
that's Big Ben. Yeah.
Wow.
This is called What a Day.
For a daydream.
With black pepper, cardamom oil, and cedarwood oil.
It's Roja here. Where we have fine fragrance here. Look at those. And then over here, fine fragrance again. And Penelope. Look how gorgeous this is. Please stop because we need to try the new The new Tobacco Color from Dior. Unfortunately, someone just said I couldn't film, so I couldn't film that experience, but I'm going to give you a review soon about it, and I kind of tell you that I really enjoyed it.
That's my ass though. Ooh la la. Ooh la la.
It's a sticky rice and mango. It's dessert from Thailand. So.
Nice.
So I'll let you try it. Intoxicated.
Thank you. This is just so sexy.
It really, really is.
There's a bit of touch of that espresso martini vibe. Like, I'm just like, oh, stunning.
It's addictive. This is what it basically wants to create, addiction.
I love that. Oh
like
my god.
The tuberose used in the Gorgon Bad in the middle age. Since Rihanna's makeup artist posted on a story.
Did he?
On Instagram. You can find it on YouTube if you go somewhere, you will see that. It went viral. This is now Love the Michel, the original is now in terms of numbers in England, our first fragrance. Because before it was like Pearl Oud or Gorgon Bad.
My god.
And now we decided to create extreme version. So double shot of the main ingredients. Double shot in the rolly, double shot of marshmallow.
It smells also, you know, very sunny, like it smelled that very sunny vibe. I don't know, like it's got like a sunshine.
It's yummy.
Something.
It's like a sweet treat for grown-ups. That's the way how we describe Love to Michelle.
Woohoo! I love that. That is beautiful.
Rihanna wears it because whenever she hugs someone, she wants that person to feel the scent.
Of course she does. Oh my god. I need to try as well a new angel chair. Because I keep saying to my followers, one day, guys, I will try it. Everyone
Let's
keeps doing.
To heaven, you'd have to try this one.
Everyone keeps telling me, like, was viral during the month of lockdown, being like, oh, that's the best one, that's the best one. I was like, guys, what is that about? I need to try it.
Straight to Heaven is, well, Killian described it as an exotic potion that will give you a moment of smoldering sensuality. But, this is Killian's point of view.
Killian's point of view is always right, isn't it?
The scent of cognac, the scent of barrels drenched in cognac. And that scent was basically like steaming and evaporating from the barrels.
That is beautiful.
Yeah.
I was not expecting that at all. I was expecting like really whiskey like you can smell a bit that, but it's not too much. It's really balanced. It's very gourmand as well. Like I want to eat it.
Like Black Phantom or even Gold Knight.
Yeah, I was
very
not
creamy.
Expecting that at all. I like it. I like that very much. And this bottle, I mean, oh gosh, it's stunning. Down the road here. Stunning,
yeah,
office kind of smell, yes, definitely. And flower of immortality, cherry blossom kind of stuff to me, like that Japanese inspirations. Beautiful,
beautiful, yeah.
Nice, stunning. Been so spoiled by Killian, honestly.
I took Rolling in Love. It's creamy almondy with a lot of tuberose, so even more creamier white flower. It's sensual, it's addictive, honestly. You need to try. And it's encapsulated in iris, so quite powdery. Big sillage, beautiful.
It's always the best service, and I absolutely love it. They told me a lot of stories. I love it. I've got my big Killian bag with my Rolling in Love, and I'm just couldn't be more happy. guys, I'm heading home. I had a fantastic day over there, as you can see. I will talk a bit more at home about my journey and everything, but honestly, it was great. And yeah, I've got like some little bags, some big bags. I'm fulfilled. I'm so happy. Right, back at home. My God, I'm tired. My legs, it's been so long I didn't go out, but I think my legs are suffering. Harrods is lovely. I had tried so many good fragrances that I can't wait to talk to you about. I've tried some new fragrances and I'm like, oh, yeah, some review coming. And the best, God, I finally have my Rolling in Love. Look at it. It gift wrapped my fragrance because it was a gift for myself. And I'm just like, so sweet. Look at that. The silk tissue, everything. I just love that. I spent time like to do my little gift. So I think I need to do a proper unboxing for this because happiness is real. Happiness is here. I was waiting for that since months. And I'm so happy I could actually do it. And you've seen, it's amazing. And I have to say, the expert that was in helping me in Killian was just the best person ever. Knowledgeable, knows his fragrance, knows the storytelling, super service, make me feel unique, special. I had such a lovely time with him. It was full of joy as well. He made me smile and I was so happy to wear my fragrance as well. And at the end, you know, it sprayed me with a combination of Love Don't Be Shy, The Extreme and Rolling in Love. And trust me, I smell absolutely stunning. I feel I could like flirt with everyone now. His name is Francesco. If you ever go to Salon de Parfum, please come and say hi and say you're coming from me. But yeah, if you want to have a good moment and learn about the fragrance, and I really spent a great time and I'm so happy. So thank you so much if you're watching this video. And guys, you need to go. Oh my God. Oh, love it. Full of happiness. Oh my God, I feel like I'm going back to life, you know. It's just, obviously this is going to be a very exceptional because I don't want to be too much in contact with people, you know. But oh, for fuck's sake, like after so many months. Anyway, I loved it. Now I'm so tired, so I'm gonna have a rest. I'm gonna play with my samples from Gucci especially. Like, I've got lots of things that I want to try. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed the little vlog, like second vlog. I hope I will do more. I will take you maybe to a different store next time. I wish I could do that in Jauveuil as well. Don't forget to subscribe, leave a little like and tell me if you enjoy that kind of format, but I loved it. And thank you so much for your support, and I will see you very, very soon. Bye now.